for the Shark robotic vacuum. When you first start up the application, this is the screen that you're brought to. You can see your actual Shark robotic vacuum right here up in the center. You also see that right now my particular robot vacuum is resting on the dock and is at 100%. On the main screen here, we have a couple of options that we can do. We can schedule something and we could say we want to do this in the morning and then select a time period, afternoon or evening. And you'll notice that it jumps you to the particular section that you want, starting with the time, but you can adjust as you see fit. Notice it changes automatically between AM and PM, which is kind of a nice touch. In my case, I'm going to go back because I don't want to actually start a schedule. Here we have our history, and this will show the history of the cleaning that the robot has done. At the top, you could see the runtime for the last 30 days. In my case, it has been 3.5 hours of runtime for particular run cleanings, and it shows that it has cleaned an area within the last 30 days of 599 square feet. The area that I actually have it cleaning is much smaller than that, so it's an accumulated total of all of these days. Yes, you'll notice that I do only run the robot vacuum once a week. If we come down here and select one of the days, it will generate the map that it has done when it was cleaning, and you'll notice it will show you if there's any spots that it kind of missed. It will show you the cleaning area, it shows you the runtime, and then information. So in this case, start cleaning, sent to dock. If you paused it to empty out the container anywhere in between this, it will show you here. You can select the X button here, which brings you back, and I'm going to open up a different one so that you can see it doesn't always get all the areas when it's out cleaning, and you can see that the total of the square footage cleaned and the runtime slightly different. We can also select the back button to bring us back to this page, and one more time because I have a slightly different map where I closed all my bedroom doors and just had it doing my hallway. So that bit right there is actually the bathroom where I have the magnetic tape across to keep it out of there, and then it just couldn't quite get into that corner, and then total runtime and clean time. Now, it does, as you saw, offer you a view of the maps. However, the maps are only visible after the cleaning job is done. You cannot view an active live map while it is out cleaning. And we're going to select back. So those are our two options there. Obviously, you've got a big clean button in the middle. We're going to swipe up from the bottom because these are notifications slash cleaning tips. Don't necessarily need to have them. And if you don't want them, you click the X right there, and that gets rid of the cleaning tip. And that just, you know, next cleaning schedule. There are some features that are only available while the Shark robot is out cleaning. And to do that, we're going to select our cleaning button right there. It is communicating to the Shark robotic vacuum right now, and it is getting ready to send it out on a cleaning cycle. The one thing that I do notice now that the robot vacuum is out cleaning, you'll see you have a pause button for the robot vacuum, stop, which is go back to the dock, or you can select find the robot and it will do a tone, which I heard, but you cannot hear. Turn off find robot, so now it will go about its business. Cleaning mode. This is the part that I dislike about this particular robot vacuum. It always defaults back to eco mode. No matter if I put it on normal or max, it always defaults back to eco. I have not found a way so that it memorizes the fact that I want maximum cleaning. I'm going to select back so I don't do that. You can see down here, it does show you cleaning time. So it's elapsed 58 seconds, and then battery remaining shows you there. It's letting you know clear the path for the robot so it can clean. I will say that this is not exactly accurate, and you do have to close the app, completely clear it from the cache of the cell phone before you open it up again, and then it'll give you an actual readout of the battery life remaining and the time. The time is just a timer that's elapsing. The battery readout, it needs to pull that data from the robot, but doesn't do it in real time when you're actually looking at the app unless you close it and start it again. So here you can see it is returning to dock, even though the battery is 100%, only because I haven't cleared anything and I didn't prepare the room for cleaning by the robot vacuum. In the upper left-hand corner, you have your hamburger button. We're going to select this. Your account at the top of the email address that you associated with your account. You have your robots. If you have several, in my case, I named the Shark robot Shark. So if you had several different variants, you can list them all out there. You can add a robot right here. You can select history, which once that loads up, gives you a cleaning history, just like you could access before. You'll notice now that there is a cleaning noted there, and if I select that, it will show me exactly what it did, and it did not really do anything because it just hadn't gotten a chance to clean yet. Coming back to our side panel, you can schedule just like you could from the front page, so we're not going to touch on that. you have your support, which will bring up a plethora of things that you can kind of quick click through in order to get basic information about your particular questions you may have. You have your settings, which will show you your profile. Cleaning error notifications that will push information to your phone. You have about this app. You have your robots. There you can see it's connectivity. It's my shark because that's what I named it. Selecting that again lets you get some extra information of the shark robot. You have your robot language. By default, I have it in English. So you can change it to a bunch of other languages. You can register your robot. You can select do not disturb, which if we turn that on, ensures your robot does not run when you need peace and quiet. So if I turn that on, you can select a time frame between which it will not actively run if you have a scheduling system. Here you have robot notification volume. Right now I have it at 50%. You can change that as you like. You can recharge and resume is off. What that means is if it does not finish your entire cleaning of a room or a floor, you can select resume, and what it'll do is it will go back to the docking station, charge itself, and then resume after. Because I have a small amount of space that it's doing, I don't really need to have that happen. You can rename your robot, you can delete the robot, you can factory reset your robot. Here you can see the serial number for the robot and the model. And there's some extra information down there, which I'm going to keep off camera. You can do add a new robot from this screen, but we're gonna come back. You can shop for more Shark products, and you can select your Shark notifications. And then you have a sign out button at the bottom there. And we are going to move back to this screen, and that is everything that you can do for the Shark robot vacuum using the Shark application.